Well, did you download the movie Dallas Buyers Club? Or perhaps more importantly, did you pay for it? Because if you didn't, you might be in a little bit of trouble.
Having won 3 Oscars and 2 Golden Globes, Dallas Buyers Club was an absolute smash hit. And as a result, plenty of Aussies have illegally downloaded it. If you just felt a little pang of guilt, beware, because the makers of Dallas Buyers Club are hunting for you. They've sought discovery orders from the federal court trying to force internet companies IINet, Internode, Dodo, Amnet and Adam Internet to give up the names and details of any of their customers who illegally torrented the movie.
This is a very new thing for Australia, but it's not new in either the US or the UK.
This year in the US, the people behind Dallas Buyers Club have already targeted more than 1,000 downloaders, seeking out-of-court settlements of up to $7,000 per offence, a practice called speculative invoicing.
It's essentially sending out a letter to the customers and saying, we've caught you downloading this movie. If you don't send us X amount of thousands of dollars, then we will take you to court and you might be forced to pay more.
Today, one of the named internet companies, IINet, has dug its heels in, posting a statement declaring that it will oppose the discovery order to protect its customers, which means the company is headed for court early next year.
If Dallas Buyers Club gets its way and gets all the customer details, you'll see many, many companies start sending out letters to customers.
So could Aussies wind up in big trouble for every movie, song and TV show they've ever illegally downloaded?
Well, Colin Jacobs is with Electronic Frontiers Australia and he joins us now. Colin, some of our viewers may have illegally downloaded some stuff. Should they be worried by all this?
Well, potentially. It's clear that Hollywood are looking to escalate the battle here in Australia. But the good news is that at least one of the internet companies, IINet, is willing to go to federal court to try and keep their members' information private. So it remains to be seen whether or not the copyright holders will actually get their hands on your members' and viewers' information.
Now, we heard earlier about how this has been successful in the States so far. If it does work, will they come looking for Australians and their money here?
They might. They're clearly looking for any way they can to discourage piracy. It's not really about the money, though. It's really about sending a message. If they can get stories and get word of mouth of people that have got these letters and you know, it's done them some harm, then mission accomplished.
Do you think, Colin, I mean, because so many Australians do steal content online, do you think it will be a deterrent? Is that the threat that will send the message to stop doing it?
Look, it's not actually stealing, which is what they're trying to do an end run around. It's a civil offence. Unless you're a massive commercial-scale pirate, it's a civil offence, which means they need to find out who you are, take you to court, prove that it actually happened, and then seek damages.
But even then, yeah, is there any way that they can pinpoint who in a particular household downloaded a particular movie from a particular Wi-Fi?
No, it's in terms of an individual person, very difficult to prove. And there have been cases in America where they've actually tried to recover damages from a printer that was on one particular internet address and was thought to be a pirate. So
did the printer pay up, Colin?
As far as I know, the printer didn't pay and is still free to print.
Enjoying movies like a mad printer.
So it could be your appliances are doing it, or it could be your kids. You don't know. But if you get the letter, how are you to know whether it was actually happened in your house or not?
Colin, 3-part question. Have you seen Dallas Buyers Club? Mm. Did you enjoy it? Did you enjoy it legally?
Unfortunately, I haven't seen it yet, and perhaps I should plead the fifth, but no, I haven't illegally downloaded it, but with all this going on now, maybe I'll be a little bit tempted.
OK, thanks for your time, Colin.
No worries, guys.
As if we weren't worried about robots taking over the world, we have to be worried about pirate printers.